Yeah, I already did a teleport tutorial, but somebody asked me to do one with some movement involved. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it.
How did you do that?
Whoa!
Holy shit!
Ow! Oh boy.
All you have to do is ask.
Hey guys, how y'all doing out there? It's time for another tutorial from Pinnacle Studio Pro. Let's jump off into this teleportation thing. Now, if you're gonna make a teleport effect, you should use a tripod. It doesn't matter if your shot's gonna be static or if you're gonna be moving, you should use a tripod. Next thing is, set up your shot, all right? Set up where you're gonna be starting your teleportation and where you're gonna be stopping it. It's vitally important for this one because we're going to be moving the tripod from one place to another. So you got to know where you're going to start it at and you got to know where you're going to stop it at so that you can stand in the correct position. So mark your spots, set it all up before you even start shooting. Let's get into the effect. Now, as you can see, if I scrub the timeline, got old boy jumping. He's just jumping straight up. That's all your talent needs to do. Jump straight up in the air and land. Alright, then I came behind the tripod and I actually moved it to the spot where I knew I wanted to land at. I went back into position and then I jumped again. So, pretty simple. Alright, now you need to do is split your clips at the right spots. So let's go back to the first spot. Yeah, I want this individual to be right up in the air when I split it. So I'm gonna go frame by frame backwards by clicking on the step backward frame button here. And when he is at the apex of his jump, just right about there, I'm going to use the razor blade and I'm gonna split this clip. Now I'm gonna go to a spot before the camera starts to move. So once again, I can use step back or step forward to find a spot right before the camera starts moving. That looks good right there, so I'm going to split the clip again with the razor blade. I'm going to delete this middle part. I'm just going to click on it to activate it and then click on the trash can. And since I have the smart timeline, it's going to jump into place. So now what you'll see if I play this is, oh boy, jump up and disappear. Boom, and then the camera moves. So now I want to get to a spot where the camera stops moving. And I'm going to use my step frame by frame buttons again to make sure that it's perfect. And this looks good right about here. So I'll split this clip again. Then I will go to the spot where old boy lands or jumps up again. So I'm going to move this forward until he's at the apex of his jump again. Kind of like Jordan got some hops up in that piece. All right, so now I'm going to go ahead and click on the razor blade again. And this time I'm going to get rid of the piece in front because this is when I'm walking over to the spot and jumping. And I want him in the air and then landing. So I'm going to go ahead and delete this this portion here. Clicking on the trash bin. And now what you have is the individual jumping, camera moving, and the individual landing. Now, if you want to, you can speed up this middle piece. If it's too slow, like if you're real careful with your movement and you find out it was too slow, you can just click on the middle piece, right-click it, go to speed, go to add, and I would pick stretch, because when you pick stretch, it locks, it anchors in the beginning and the end part of the clip. It anchors in the beginning and the end of the clip, and then all you got to do is just trim the clip, and what it'll do is just speed it up instead of actually taking parts off of it. If I wanted to speed that up, just trim it a little bit, and now you'll see it'll move over fast into place. Right now it's still kind of rendering it and everything, but it'll move faster when it's done rendering. And boom, you're done. Alright, so basically you got your teleport effect. Just like that, you're in spot, you're good to go. Now, if you want to, you could add smoke, you could add sound effects, you could add whatever else you want to it, and it's pretty much a wrap. One thing I do want to talk about is if you do decide to add like smoke or whatever, let's say if I added smoke to this, let's go up here, let's get these here. So if you want to add smoke, there's something that you got to make sure you do at the beginning. When you do your movement, you're going to have to use keyframes to make the smoke go with the movement of the camera so that when you add the smoke, it just doesn't stay in the same place and everything else moves. To give you an idea, you drag this down into the timeline here. Alright, so I'm going to right click on the smoke. And what I did just then is I just added a timeline marker to get the smoke somewhere where he's jumping so I can see them both at the same time. I'm going to move that after this. I'm going to go to Open Effects Editor. And the first thing you want to do is go to Keyers. And if you have a green background, you're going to use Studio Chroma Key. If you got a black background, you're going to use Luma Key. So I want to step forward to a position where I can see the subject and the actual smoke at the same time. And this is why I kind of used that timeline marker and moved it over so that I can see them both together. Now I'm going to go to my settings. I'm going to do a few quick things on here just to get rid of all that black. You may have to use different settings for your Luma Key, okay? This is just what I'm using for right now. Now, what I want to do next is go to 2D, 3D. And I'm going to go to 2D Editor Advanced. I'm going to change it from default to no preset. And it puts it back where it should be. Now, I'm going to use size to bump up the size. And you want it to be a big enough size to where it actually covers dude at the top of his jump. So I'll move the vertical up here. You want to get this somewhere where it's touching the ground so it looks more realistic. So if I step through and use my by frame button, you'll see it's pretty much at the top of his jump where he was a few frames ago. It actually covers where he was. So that's good. So I like that where it's at. So for now, I'm going to click OK. And you'll see now that when old boy jumps, fire or smoke comes up and boom, he's good to go. So I can leave this where it's at. If you want to, you can remove this marker and move it back to start at the same place where he disappears. It's up to you. I'm not going to do all that right now, but what I am going to do is just show you one more thing. Go back to Open Effects Editor. Matter of fact, let's cancel this. I want to move my scrubber right to the point where the camera move starts before I do this, because I want, when I activate the keyframes, I want the keyframes to start here, which means that I don't have to worry about the first part of it, doing keyframing every single bit of it. I'm going to go back to Open Effects Editor. I'm going to go back to 2D Editor Advanced, and now I'm going to activate keyframes at this point. You'll notice that it made two keyframes, and it's not going to move between these two frames. The smoke will stay at the same spot. But as soon as I step forward a frame, you'll see some movement start. And what you need to do is go to position and make the horizontal match a spot on here all the way through so that it moves with the picture. Because right now it just stays in the middle where I put it. You don't want that. You got to keyframe it out. All you're going to do is just move. Let's say, I don't know, I'll just show you real quick. See, if I move, step forward a frame and I see there's movement. Well, now I just need to, wherever the scrubber's at, just add what I want it to be. Say I want it to be negative 13 to move it to the left some. Boom, so now it's moved. And then I go to the next frame, do the same thing if it moves. Just type in the numbers where you think it should go. You should use a point of reference on the screen that you can make sure that the left side always touches. Whether it's a piece of grass, a dark spot, whatever it is, use that as a reference. All right, so I'm gonna cancel that out because basically that's it. Add your sound effects, and it's a wrap, baby. All right? You guys know the routine. The thumb, the one that's pointed in the upward direction, click it, like it, live it, love it, hug it. Show the thumb some love. Comments. You know I love comments, all right? Leave me your comments about this video. Tell me whether you like it or not, what you would like to see me do next, all of that good stuff. If you need help, I'll try to help you. If I can't help you, I'll point you in the right direction to make sure you get the help that you deserve. And last, but definitely not least, don't you ever forget to subscribe, baby. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again soon. We'll be right back.